Breonna Taylor, protest to mark anniversary of police killing. People are gathering in the U.S. city of Louisville for a demonstration to mark a year since the death of Breonna Taylor, a 26-year-old black medic shot dead when police raided her home. The incident caused outrage, spurring protests against racism and brutality. Ms. Taylor was shot by officers who forced entry into her home using a no-knock warrant that meant they did not have to announce themselves. The three police officers who carried out the raid were eventually sacked. During the operation, Ms. Taylor's boyfriend Kenneth Walker shot and wounded one of the officers. Earlier this month, a charge of attempted murder against him was dropped. Mr. Walker said he fired once because he believed criminals were breaking in. The officers responded with 32 shots, 6 of which struck Ms. Taylor. However, a grand jury decided not to charge any of them over Ms. Taylor's death, sparking protests. Ahead of Saturday's demonstration, Kentucky Governor Andy Beshear said in a statement that he would never understand the unimaginable grief of Ms. Taylor's family and loved ones. "Today we remember Breonna Taylor, her tragic and unnecessary loss and the immense work we have ahead of us," he said. Ms. Taylor's killing did not initially attract nationwide attention. But it received renewed focus after the police killing of unarmed black man George Floyd in Minneapolis, which ignited anti-racism protests around the world. Her case attracted the support of celebrities such as tennis star Naomi Osaka and basketball legend LeBron James. A U.S. Department of Justice investigation is ongoing. The city of Louisville paid $12 million, £8.6 million, to Ms. Taylor's family and agreed to police reforms to settle the wrongful death lawsuit. Only one of the police officers who took part in the deadly raid faced any charges linked to the botched raid. Brett Hankison was charged with endangering Ms. Taylor's neighbors by firing into a next-door apartment. Earlier this week, the city of Minneapolis reached a $27 million settlement with George Floyd's family. That the largest pretrial settlement in a wrongful death case ever would be for the life of a black man sends a powerful message that black lives do matter and police brutality against people of color must end, said Floyd family attorney Ben Crump. Jury selection is underway for the murder trial of police officer Derek Chauvin, who was filmed with his knee on Mr. Floyd's neck as he begs for his life and says, "I can't breathe." He was later pronounced dead in hospital.